religion, but we go deeper into the aspects as far as the core of what religion is. So when you are studying religion, you are studying the physical aspect of metaphysics, which is the soul. And that's spirituality. That's what we are, we're spiritual beings. All right? So tonight, we're going to do a Q&A. So if y'all got any questions pertaining to metaphysics, as far as dreams and things like that, shoot away.
I do. This might sound random to some, but I have a super deep connection to
Before you go further, let's stop. Nothing sounds crazy when it comes to truth, because truth lives in everything. It lies in everything. You are truth. So when you're speaking, you are actually creating vibrational frequencies, which is fragments of the truth. Every time you create a word, this is your thought. You are your thoughts. So every time you speak, you are speaking fragments of yourself, which is from your soul, your mind. This is your true body. Your physical body is your brain. That's not you. So therefore, he who controls the mind controls you, because you are the mind. So nothing is crazy. Let's get that straight before we go forward. All right?
Okay.
Go ahead.
So I've always felt the connections to mermaids. Like, I feel as though I myself was possibly even a mermaid in my past life. And I remember being a young girl, and I've had dreams twice where they came to me in a dream, and it felt so real, where I was like really, really calm, and I just kind of like went with that on it. And I really, that's always been on my mind, and I don't know what to make of it.
Well, when you study in mermaids, they do exist, and they have whole civilizations in Zimbabwe. Like I said before, you get my book, The Melanin Dream World Infiltration, talks about how the United States military went to Zimbabwe in the 90s, and they tried to surround the oceans. And under the oceans, they had civilizations of beings that came up and snatched a few of the workers. And so when they tried to put it in the news, the witch doctor in Zimbabwe said that would not be wise for you to do it because they don't like attention. So mermaids is actually people who are in kinship to the gurus. When you study the star system Sirius A, this is a feminine star system. So this is probably why you are connected to that being. So you probably going to be one in future life, or you were one in the past life.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Or you can be one right now, exist as somewhere else, because we exist as the whole universe right now. So we are everywhere. You are living in another dimension right now. So you might go to sleep and dream about fragments of yourself that's existed somewhere else right now. You get what I'm saying? So you may be a mermaid existed somewhere else right now. So, yeah. Don't be scared now. Ask your questions. You know, you want to ask about death. Because remember that death only exists because somebody taught it to you. Right? So it's a frequency that we put upon ourselves to oppress the true aspect of who we really are. Like I said, when we speak English languages, we are speaking low frequencies. You get what I'm saying? So what is life? Right now, you are asleep. When you dream, you wake up. The left brain, right brain theory. So when somebody tells you you're going to sleep, they actually tell you, I'm going back to reality. I'm going back to my rightful mind. You get what I'm saying? So right now, you are downloading information to take back to your reality. You have to come to the physical in order to live or exist in the reality, which is, this is the illusion. This is the matrix. This is important. A lot of people say the third dimension is not important. It's very important because you have consciousness to make things right that you didn't do in the past life. So a lot of people that come here and they go through negative situations and events is because of what they did in the last life, in the past life. So everything that happened here is a reflection of what's going on somewhere else. You get what I'm saying? So anybody else have any more questions?
Astral projection?
Astral projection? You're astral projecting right now. Every time you speak a word, again, that's a fragment of you. See, you never leave the body. You always dwell in the mind. People say, I'm leaving here to go somewhere. You never go anywhere. There's no such thing as going somewhere. You always, when you so-called die here, a part of your brain shut down and another part opened up. You go into another body. Your mind is bigger than what you think. But because you're seeing through these two physical lenses, it's showing, just like time here. In the dream world, you can go into the dream world for an hour and it seems like you're there forever. And then you wake up and be like, damn, how long have I been asleep? And you only been asleep 30 minutes. Because when you study time and space, you have to understand that your thoughts here move more slower than your thoughts in the fifth dimension. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, this is why they had to create religion to shut us down. And when you go into the metaphysics of religion and you study religion, you will see that they use that to oppress a certain part of you that is now awakening. You have certain celestial beings in the constellations that's awakening now, that's a part of the Council of the Mothers. You are all Council of the Mothers to the so-called black woman and woman. You have something unfolding in you. And this is why they are trying to kidnap our children. 65% of young black females are now in Dos, New Mexico, and they're doing experiments on them because they have a second pineal gland, and they're trying to figure out why they are now producing this. Because we have a new entity coming in, and they are using their bodies to carry out certain things. Even the homeless people, when you study the homeless people, they're not human beings out there. These are people that come from underground. They live in the sewage yard. They go down into the sewage yard. They come out at 3 a.m. in the morning. It sounds crazy, but it's real. But that's why you have FEMA bands coming out, kidnapping them, taking them to underground facilities, throwing them in incinerators, taking their organs, black market organ harvest. Because melanin is worth $353 a gram. So you think they go into other countries to kill for resources such as diamonds when your DNA is worth more than diamonds? Probably not. They need the bodies. These reptilians that live in the inner earth of Hollywood, they are now going extinct, and they need the information that is now being sent from these full moons into your body. Every night there's a full moon. Your mother tell you that, well, it's new life during a full moon. But right now, we're giving birth to children. You get what I'm saying? So there's a full moon every time you are giving birth. And not only that, but you are the only being with two X chromosomes. You have the X-Man gene in you. You are the one that's giving birth to the X-Men. They're talking about you every time they make these movies. But we see it as entertainment. Do you get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So for the mere fact that you're looking at it as entertainment, your brain is actually dumbing you down. You are dumbing yourself down. Because it's just like, if I drink alcohol and smoke weed, and I do it for activity, my mind already gonna process it as an activity. It's gonna shut me down. But if I smoke an ounce of weed right now, and I say I'm doing it to get into other gateways and other dimensions, it's gonna actually help me get there. Because everything is manifested through the mind again. It's like the word God. Who is God? What is God? If the word God is only 600 years old, and we find in precious black women, anthropologists, finding your body over 3 million years old, then you are older than a God. That's why I don't refer to you as a God. I'm not down to you, but I'm saying that you are more than a God. Because God can't exist without a mind. God is what? A word. A word can't exist without a thought. So God needs you in order to exist. Our melanin is like a projection. So whatever they give you, if it's an agenda and you put it in your mind, you project it and you create their reality for them. Do you get what I'm saying? So we have to stop taking things at face value and saying that, okay, well, for example, a lot of people say I'm pseudo. I love those accusations because it lets me know that I'm more spiritual than physical. Now, how I address that is this right here. If you believe that the earth exists, and I say that the inner earth exists, and you're saying that I'm a pseudo for that, then who taught you that the earth exists? Now you pseudo. That's contradictory. Because you're telling me how do you know that the inner earth exists? How do you know that the earth exists? Who taught you that? And I guarantee you have to tell me that a white man taught you that shit. You can't tell me that you taught yourself that because you ain't know nothing about the earth when you came out of your mother's womb. As a matter of fact, your brain capacity was on a 100% functioning component inside of the womb until you came out and started crying. When you first use your tongue, 85% of your brain shut down. Our ancestors didn't speak. It's like they didn't eat like that. When you talk too much, your brain have to work overtime, and it stresses the mind. It's just like when you sleep. When you eat food at past 7 o'clock p.m., you go to sleep. You sleep 10 hours, you wake up, you're still tired. Why? Because your brain, your stomach is a brain. It has to think. It's breaking down that food that you put in your body, those GMOs. So therefore, it's working overtime. It's like you never slept. You get what I'm saying? So right now, we have a new kind of melanin that is formulated within the pineal gland of all of us. And they are afraid. So then you see more killings. It's just like when they pull you over in the car. When the police pull you over, the magistrate, the clerk, everybody gets your medical records right downtown. Because when you go into the DMV and you apply and you say you want to be an organ donor, that becomes your property, even though you're already that property. So when they pull you over and they see the number on your car, they say, hey, somebody from the private organization or private corporation is willing to pay $5 million for this organ. It's a match. Not only that, but your heart is an organ. So when they say organ donor, they're talking about every organ in your body. So therefore, if it matched, they tell them, shoot them down. Shoot them down. We want the money. We don't really care about them. You get what I'm saying? But I don't want to step too far off the metaphysics of religion. When you study a religion, you are studying the most important person of religion is who? Christ, which is the Christos or the Horus, as people in the Kemetic doctrine say. Even though I'm not Kemetic or I don't claim to be African, but when you study the Christ, this is your third eye, this is your pineal gland. Because Christ died and rose on what? The third day. Your third eye. And you have 12 systems in the brain, whereas the European only have 6 systems. So when you are studying the 12 systems in the brain, that's connected to what? To the 12 zodiacs. 12 zodiacs are the 12 disciples. So they took your body, they took everything inside of you and created a religion out of you. They took your soul, and in return for your soul, they gave you a book. And now you're enslaved. Look at what religion is doing for us today. Emotions casted a spell on us. So now we're running around in church, falling, looking like ignorant fools, running up and down the aisle, falling out like flies.
So you don't believe that people catch the Holy Spirit?
I mean, again, it starts here. You can make yourself get sick. I can create a virus right now, make myself sick, if I'm determined. Remember, every thought is a frequency. And signals start here. So, of course, they can make themselves, a crazy person can make themselves crazy if they want to. I know people getting checks out here and they're not really crazy. They make themselves crazy. You get what I'm saying? So, you can do anything with the mind. You get what I'm saying? But, you know, when you study a religion, you're looking at the body. There's nothing wrong with religion. You just have to know how to read it. It's like the Freemasons. They swear they got a lot of knowledge, but they just as dumb. 33 degrees, water freezes around that same element. And water represents what? Life. So that means that your life is frozen. These are Boy Scouts. They're 720 degrees. Now, when I talked to a Mason and he said, well, you got to take that 33 and you have to divide it and then multiply, then I say, I know what you're talking about. Because that 3 times 3 is 9. That's that 9 ether. So that's 720 degrees. 7 plus 2 is 9. They're all in kinship with each other. And this is your DNA. This is the sequence of your DNA. This is why I say the black woman is the master Mason. Because she carries the 9 ether in her womb for 9 months before she gives birth to that entity that carries that one X chromosome. So it doesn't make us weak as males, but we are the servants of that element. You get what I'm saying? That's what Sirius A and Sirius B stand for. Sirius A and Sirius B are the 2X chromosomes. You get what I'm saying? So yeah. Anybody got any more questions?
Giving out paper for y'all. I need to tell you how we can get y'all questions if y'all had any questions. Okay. Any paper you, as it keeps going, maybe a little bit longer, you may want to write a question down. So I'm going to leave the paper right here.
Yeah, don't be afraid. See, the thing is, when we are gathering like this is the ancestors gathering. They only using us as antennas to communicate. And you have DNA in you right now that wants to awaken. But due to your silence, you are oppressing. You are keeping yourself enslaved. You get what I'm saying? So for the mere fact that we are gathering here today means that somebody has something that needs to be awakened. My words is vibration. Every time you hear me, I'm in your mind. I'm residue in your mind. So you might go to sleep tonight with a part of me in you. And when you awaken in the morning, you get what I'm saying? You might have something answered to the point where a part of me is not here to answer that for you. So I'm not going to be here to answer your questions. I can answer your questions by astral projecting by way of my vibrational frequency. So this is why I tell people, don't a closed mouth don't get fed. If you have any questions, ask questions. The ancestors is here.
How do you connect with the ancestors consciously?
Well, the ancestors, you really don't connect with the ancestors. You are the ancestors. It's just that you are a modem. It's just like internet. Right now, they are using you to take information back out of this body of intelligence, this physical body of intelligence, into another body of intelligence. All the thoughts that you think of here, everything that you learn here, is going to turn physical in another dimension. So right now you're building a house to go into after you leave this body. You get what I'm saying? So the more intelligence you gain here, the more intelligent you will be in another life. Like right now, you may have been an elder in a past life. You get what I'm saying? I'm going to give you a good example. Martin Luther King. He might be somewhere right now and don't know that he was a powerful figure here. And we honoring him. You have people honoring you in other dimensions right now. And you don't know it. You get what I'm saying? That's because you exist in many places at once. So you are your ancestors. Never look outside of yourself for anything. They all are connected. They all inside of you connected. You get what I'm saying? We all connect. We want. We're on the same frequency right now. For the mere fact that we all at attention, we're on the same frequency. Whether we disagree or agree, we're on the same frequency. And this is this is magic right here. You get what I'm saying? So don't be afraid to ask questions. Connect. You know, when you hang up the phone, you know, we can't connect.
How do you feel about getting free from the workplace?
Say
that again. When it comes to the workplace.
Say that again.
For me, like, when it comes to working, it's very hard for me. I feel like before I was probably like a queen somewhere.
Right.
Telling people what to do. Because it's hard for me to stay at one job at one time and enjoy it and
right.
Stay there. So I'm just trying to figure
well,
out.
This is the thing here. Sometimes people get in positions of management and then they leave that job and go somewhere else. Then they have to fall down and then work their way up again. It doesn't make it bad. It's just that they get experience in every dimension or every life that they go into. So you may have been appointed in a past life, but you work enough to become something more higher than a queen in another life. That's all that is. So you're not working for nobody. You're working for yourself. This is what I tell people. When you get up and you go to work in the morning, put it in your mind that you're working for yourself. Because again, when you say that you're going to work for them, then you're giving them credit. You're keeping their illusion alive. You get what I'm saying? So we have to let this arrogance go. A lot of people saying we need to stop, we need to get black banks. There's no such thing as a black bank. Show me one black bank and I can give you my savings. I don't give a damn if every employee in there is black. It's run by the FDIC, which is the international bankers. These are reptilians. These are not humans. So they got you looking at money while they looking at your DNA. You think that money is important and valuable, but your DNA is important. You have enough DNA in you right now to wrap around the universe infinity. There's no number to how many times your DNA can wrap around this universe. And look at this little body that you're in.
So what is it going to take at this point for us as a people to recognize and like do something about it?
Well, the thing is, why do we have to do anything? Just like my teacher, Bobby Hemmings, said, we're not here to liberate on the physical because you're not physical beings.
Mm-hmm.
You get what I'm saying? So if you're here to play their game, which means to liberate yourself here, they love that because you're giving attention to their dimension.
Mm-hmm.
You only here, they cannot harm you. When you're spiritual, what they do physically to you don't harm you, don't bother you at all. Because you're not physical. For the mere fact that you can feel something don't mean that it's real. It's the things that you can't feel that's real. Again, I said the unknown is your reality, but sometimes if you can't control your reality, you get what I'm saying? Then somebody else will. And that's what's going on here. We make things complicated, but in all actuality, it's simple. All we have to do is let go and stop looking for liberation. Your liberation is already unfolded, it's already manifested. What can they do to you? The real you. I'm not talking about this. What can they do to the real? They already trying to really get to you. But what can you do to something that you can't touch? You can't do that. So, you know, I don't care how many businesses you got. It's no, like I said, it's no such thing as a black business. If they gave us our 40 acres and a mule, we're going to all get right back. We'll be buying rams. They're going to set up some type of incentive program where we give the money back to them. And say, I told y'all, we gave y'all money. And now guess what? Y'all ain't this shit. Just like Obama. Everybody voted for Obama so quick because it's physical. But the Hispanics said, we ain't voting for you. Even though the votes don't care. But they said, we're not voting for you. For the mere fact that it was acknowledged by the people
You get what I'm saying? He had to uphold his promise to the Hispanics. Now when we see Hispanics, they got temporary agencies that their family didn't go work at. They have medical facilities. We only voted for Obama because he was black. You still physical. As long as we look at the physical, we're going to always keep the physical alive. We are in a computer. You are the thoughts or the megahertz inside the computer. Now you have to give them a virus. Just like they're giving you a virus, now you have to give them a virus by awakening. You get what I'm saying? So that's how we have to do it. We got to stop giving our energy and attention and being emotional every time they do something to something that's not us. So when I hear about somebody getting shot down, I don't care about that. Oh, you cold-hearted. How the hell am I cold-hearted? I'm spiritual. I know that that's not them. You shooting down something that's going into the ground. You can't kill energy. It don't die. That's what you are. Everything around you is energy. That's how we connect.
Question, but what are your thoughts on recurring numbers? Like for instance, I keep having like my birthday 7/19. Mm-hmm. I see, like, I wake up at 7/19. I look at my cell phone at 7/19.
Wow.
I was like literally afraid for my birthday to come this year because I was telling my cousin, my sister, something good, something bad's gonna happen, and it passed.
Right. Which one were you born?
7/19.
So that'd be your birthday in your next life. See, usually when you pass away here, if I passed away tonight, that'd be my birthday in my next life. But since you are seeing the reoccurring number of your birthday, you're going to be reborn again, except for you're going to have a higher element that controls you. When I say a higher element, I'm talking about you're going to have within the constellations, this is where you make your contracts at. So therefore, you're going to be connected to an elder energy. See, all energy is not the same. You have dumb energy, then you have energy of intelligence. When you study the DNA of Europeans, they have dumb energy. This is the melanin. They have melanin, but it's dumb melanin. It's dumb energy. Melanin is not DNA. Melanin is a spiritual element that they cannot see. I don't give a damn if you upgrade your electron microscopes, you cannot see melanin through a microscope. There's no color in it. When you look at the movie Lucy, they made it blue because they wanted you to see it as a facade. It's not blue. CPH4 is something that only the black woman, the so-called black woman, carry, and that's the amniotic fluid. What they were showing you in that movie that opened up the brain capacity of that woman was the amniotic fluid. This is why they get you to come back in pregnancy and they take it away from you. Your placenta, your umbilical cord, that's the CPH4. And they take it away from you and they sell it to private corporations and they do biological patents with your DNA. You get what I'm saying? So now they have underground civilizations where you have certain people living that's actually taking your umbilical cord and they're eating it. And they're doing rituals with your stuff. And then you wonder why you're getting attacked. You wake up and now you got scratches all over your body. Or you get attacked in your dream. This very television right here. If there's a problem going on and they want to make a military weapon and your DNA holds the substance to create that weapon, because remember, the atom bomb was created using neural melanin. The solar panels on these high rises and skyscrapers was created using our neural melanin. So their buildings wouldn't burn. That's why the sun don't burn us. By photosynthesis, we bring in information and it downloads information into our biological bottom, our computer. So when you're looking at this television, it has a satellite in it. And it's probably about that big. And these Gwen towers that you see blinking red and blue on nights of full moons, they know that these full moons is actually sending something to your neural melanin, and they want to block that information because they see that the chemtrails are no longer working. Hmm. See, the chemtrails is used to create certain process clouds, but the real clouds is the portals. We don't have no more real clouds no more because the ancestors said, you know what? We see what they're trying to do. So we're going to take these clouds with us, and they're going to go underground. Just like the suns. They have pyramids in these suns. These are telecommunications. These are transportation centers. Our ancestors knew how to get to a pyramid and align it with density and time. Because from here to the door is a specific time. See, it's the details that gives us superiority. So from this door, from here today, I say it's 10 seconds. They can create a shape that coincides with 10 seconds and study the light density, create a light density between here and the door, and lay between here and the door, a certain feet between here and the door, and they can travel with their thoughts. See the cell phone that you have in your pocket right now? That's your mind right there. It's melanin in there. Melanin is used to carry information. It's used to carry frequencies and vibrations. So that's the process, you. You are a real cell phone. You are a real internet. Every time you think, you are putting something inside of your address, www.what? You create whatever internet site you want to go to. So we sit here talking and we building and you saying, well, what about this? What's going on? You asking me a question. You are actually typing something in to my web address. And when you hit enter, guess what? The information you're researching comes up by way of what I'm saying out of my mouth. See, everything now has become complicated. Technology has dumbed us down. You get what I'm saying? So anybody got any other questions? You have to see now, our ancestors dealt with math in a different jurisdiction. They understood that numbers and sequences identified our characteristics as far as our spiritual mind. So what they would do is, if they saw 1111, they would do something for 11 days and ask for something in their favor. Because numbers is people too. And you have to study the 11th planet. Everything, every time you see a reoccurring number, study the 11th planet, study the 11th hour, study your 11th system in your brain, and then come up with a conclusion. See, you cooking. See, ingredients don't only occur in the kitchen. Ingredients occur with intelligence. So numbers is the basis for whatever you are cooking, because you can't exist without numbers. You have to calculate a thought in order to think. You have an address, so that means they have to put some of their GPS and calculate wherever you live at. It's a reason for all that. You have a social security number because they're calculating what type of dementias that you have flowing through your DNA. In your blood, they can look at your nucleus. They can send it to certain CERN machines. The CERN is not only to create portals. The CERN is used to open up portals inside of your subconscious mind. Yes, they can open up portals in the universe because the universe is you. The universe is your subconscious mind. So whatever is going on outside of you is going on inside of you. You get what I'm saying? This is the basis of everything. Everything around you affects you. You are your environment. The person that's across the street robbing a bank, you're part of that. How is that? Because that person that's across the street from you have energy emanating that environment, and you picking up on that energy. So you might as well, you might go into the next life and wonder why you rob a bank. You picked up on that, you digesting that, the people's energy around you. It's like with people, you see rapists and all that stuff coming here. This is because this is a reflection of something they did in that past life. They did something, or somebody who get raped here. It might sound cold, but our emotions get in the way. Somebody might get raped here. This is not all cases though, but in the past life, they raped somebody else. They raped somebody else's child. So now it happens to them here. The laws of attraction is real. It's not fake. It's real. People be like, I can't understand what is happening to me. Why it happened to me? But remember that it's bigger than you. And you don't just extend here. You extend far out to the unknown, which is your reality. And you don't control nothing.
Do the same rules apply, like when they say if it doesn't fall when the man falls on his child?
Well, that's true, because you are your child. I was looking at a movie the other night, and they were saying that the reason why the husband and the wife fight is because the daughter and the father fight because there was husband and wives in the past life. I believe that because I believe everywhere you go, you magnetically attract people to you that you were with in the past life. I don't care if they're best friends, husband, wives, teachers, etc. You know what I'm saying? You might be with one of your teachers that you can teach you. It happens. But again, if it skips you on your child, that's because you are no longer under the spell of what happened.
They want fresh stuff. I'm gonna give you a good example. A child's DNA is more imminent than an adult. So the reptilian, if they choose somebody's body, they would choose a child's body because it's innocent. And innocent DNA tastes more better to them. You get what I'm saying? So for the mere fact that it skips you into your child, that's they just reenacting the metaphysics of time. That's how time deal with us. Time wants the most innocent. It's gonna put whatever you did in your past on the most innocent. So if I did some of my past life, it's gonna fall on my son. It's like if I rape somebody's child in my past life, and my son gets raped, then that's time. You have to respect faith. You have to respect that. It sounds cold, but that's the laws of attraction. What you do to somebody else will happen to you. When I say you, not necessarily you directly, but somebody that you created from your mind. Again, if I create a child, he comes from my mind. Faith will mess up my mind. So sperm is brain fluid, and I create a child with somebody else, then fate is going to mess up my mind, which is my child. My child was a part of my mind at one time. My child is my thought. Everything is connected. Everything. Go ahead.
I came late, but I do think about energy. I'm clairvoyant. Not clairvoyant. They're two different things. I don't know if you guys know the difference between the two. One is clairvoyance. People think, you know, you're kind of psychic. You can kind of tell people. Clairvoyance is I can feel energy. So like with me, I can pretty much know where a person is. I may not know all the details surrounding, but I can know what there is. Also, like, I have periods where I have to remove myself from people altogether, just to kind of clear my energy field. And so I'm at a place where I can recognize what energy is what. So I do look and I see energy and feel energy differently but there are a lot of people who are clairvoyant. They just don't fully understand it, but as a person that studied it, it's just easier for me to understand from that perspective. So I do agree with some of the things you're saying. I don't agree with everything that you're saying. From that perspective, when you guys are talking about your numbers, everyone has numbers. At this age in our life, you should be at a place where you kind of understand what those numbers mean, as far as what your numbers are. I know for me, when I see my numbers, it means that something really good is about to happen. Also, but being able to discern what energy is your energy and what energy is energy you picked up from others around you is really crucial and really major in what you're feeling. Also, knowing how to clear your energy field is very crucial and very major. And just living a productive thing in life day to day. Especially like in environments like this, when you bring a lot of people into your home, it's very important that you know how to clear that energy. But I do think that there are things that are generational. There are things that, as far as energy goes, because it's something that is lost. I think the energy of you is the spirit of you, and that's what connects you, you know, to the higher and everyone else is around you. Like I always tell my friends, like with all the people that you pass on a daily basis and you interact with, you have to really respect those that you do lock in on. And you have to ask yourself, well, why did I lock in on you? Why was I drawn or attracted to you?
Right.
Because that's an energy. Mm-hmm. So you have to be, you know, recognize those things. But not in like, I don't like when people kind of deal with it though, like in like a scary way. It's just who you naturally are. Your energy being is you. And you've been talking about it all your life. It's just people talk about it in different ways. Religious people talk about it, letting your light shine, you know, or that light, you know, metaphysical people, they talk about it in forms of like chakras and the universe and things of that nature. People have been talking about energy for years. It's just you don't use the same terminologies depending on your upbringing and, you know, the people who raised you and your surroundings, your friends and things of that nature.
Right. Well, I'm going to finish off by saying this. When you are talking about numbers, I agree with you when you say that certain things is about to happen, but it's not necessarily good things because it's not always the good that
manifests
the. I know what you're talking about. It's not always the good that gets us to our destiny. We need to be pushed into a corner. Mm-hmm. so that we can be not alleviated, but to a point where we are pressured. Because when you put gold into a furnace, it becomes pure. So you can't become pure with using numbers to make you become better. Better things comes out of hardship.
I was thinking in terms of my
No, I know what you're saying. I understand what you're saying. But at the same time, when you study energy fields, it's handicapped. Only handicapped people can see energy fields. When you study autistic children, they see notes. We hear music, but they see the notes. They can see what we are playing. You get what I'm saying? I get calls all the time by women who saying their child, they saw their child on a bed Indian style playing with beams. This is because they're in two different dimensions at one time. We are only in one dimension. Handicap is actually a superiority. So when we are talking about seeing numbers, everybody have their own side effect. When you are seeing numbers and you are seeing different figures, you are having a side effect of something that is going on with your change. When the full moon is occurring, the universe is shifting a certain number. It's shifting in a certain diaspora where a number is actually communicating with that shift. So we have an age for a reason. But if you were 17 and I was 17, we wouldn't be the same age. They just say that. Because it's not the physical that caused you to be your age, it's your soul. So I can look at my mother and she could be doing things like a child. And she's older than me physically, but soul-wise, I'm doing things that's in the jurisdiction of eldership. So that caused me to be much older than my mother. So numbers do play a role in identifying the things that we come into contact with. But when we are talking about changing and going into directions to better ourselves, we're talking about hardship. Hardship is what changes us. When we talk about positive things, sometimes the positive won't change you because it makes you comfortable. You can't be comfortable and change. You get what I'm saying? So yeah. But I agree with you. I know what you're saying.
I feel like Cleo got a question. Where's Cleo? Is Cleo in here? Cleo got a question.
Everybody, you have a question?
Are you familiar with the book The Secret?
That's actually a rewrite.
It's a rewrite.
So she read The Master Key System. Those are the books that, I don't know if you ever seen, like the prequel. Those are the books that she talked about when she was in that space. Mm-hmm. And so her book is basically a rewrite. It's kind of like a dumbed down version of The Science of Getting Rich. Or that's the key system is a meditation process. It takes a long time to master. Mm-hmm. It's a good book, but like they'll give you like one little simple thing and then they'll give you like a week to kind of master it. It actually takes weeks to master each little section of the book. We've kind of gotten away from our God state and everything that connects us to God and all the things that we are capable of doing within ourselves. So what the book is trying to do is it's trying to get you to kind of let go of all of the restrictions that, from years and years pretty much of, society being enforced on us so that you can be free enough to connect to the higher power and source and know what your full energy capability is.
Are you supposed to secret or
the Master Key System? The Secret is so thorough. It's 70 pages. It's so thorough. You can buy it. You can download it for free. You can listen to it for free. You can, download it, a written copy for free. I would recommend doing both. It's thorough.
I mean, I hear some of what he's talking about. I read it years
ago. Well, the thing is, when you're talking about getting back to our God self, you have to remember that man created God, and that's his frequency. So in order for us to get back to our God self, that means that we have to find out where God came from. Again, a man created God. So now you're going back to the jurisdiction of religion.
No, not necessarily.
So yes, because the thing is, let me just answer this. If we keep on using the frequency God, we are placing a spell on ourselves because it is God who is oppressing us today. When you hear the word God, what do you hear? You hear superior, right? And you shouldn't do this because God is against this. Or you're going to hell. God can send you to hell.
No, this is
when we first heard about it, I understand that, but who created God? God came from one person. And I know who that one person is. And it's not somebody who looked like you. So, but yeah, it was a white man. So why would we keep on using his frequencies to oppress ourselves? You can't keep on using the word God to tie to yourself because what you're doing, words is powerful. You have to watch what you say and what you're putting on yourself.
Well, there are many gods.
No. There are many gods, but at the same time, the word God itself was created by one person. And we didn't create it. If you go back 5,000 years to Kemet, our ancestors didn't speak the word God. They didn't speak at all. I just now said before you came, I said they didn't use their tongue at all. They used this. This is what they used. So they didn't say God in their mind because English didn't exist. English never existed. Everybody, I mean, I respect your viewpoints. But what I'm saying is I'm here to make you think. That's why I'm here. This is why she invited me.
Is it telepathically we were doing this back in the day? Or was it?
This is how they made the concept of the pyramid. Pyramid has certain points. See, the thing is, you have shapes, and shapes determine how communication flows and which direction communication flows. Just like your body. You cannot move your body unless your brain sends a signal to your body to move. You get what I'm saying? So in order for emotion to happen, there has to be some type of friction and thought. And so again, your mind, if I create a word to put on your mind, it's low frequency, and you say that you are that word, then you become that word. And if you become sick, if I had an agenda to make you sick through that word, words are not just something that you hear. Words are like people. People can stress you. People can kill you. People can make you sick. So if you say that you are this, if your slave master created something, and then you try to make the word positive today, right? If I was somebody who created God, and I was a white man, right? And then later on, we say, you know what? We're going to use the word God to make it a good word and use it toward ourselves today. It still don't make it good. You know why? Because the way that you say a word determines the frequency of your body. I can make you sick just by saying certain words and then your body chanting it over and over again. When you chant words, your body
is energy. That's what healing, and that's what
you allow someone to.
No. What I'm saying is right here. Certain things happen to you unconsciously. See, just because it don't happen to you and you don't see it and recognize it, how does cancer come up? It's been in your body. You can have cancer in your body right now. You don't acknowledge it. The doctor can't see it or nothing like that. Hold on a second. Let me explain myself. Because hold on, I was invited here. She invited me here now. Come on now. If she invites me here to speak, at least give me the decency to explain myself.
Well, I mean,
it's not a conversation. I'm trying to explain myself.
It's a conversation.
I understand that. Let me explain myself though. With all due respect, because she invited me.
Yeah, I did. And that's why I gave everybody papers to write.
And my wife, you know what I mean? She gets up at 3 a.m. and I said, I'll come.
Yeah.
So that's
why I gave everybody papers.
Right. So you got questions, write it down. You
can ask a question and then we can kind of cover that topic, if you have a question. But I mean, we are going to have different views.
It don't matter exactly.
But that's not what this forum is for, like our views, but just trying to get some perspective of the metaphysics.
Let me just say one thing.
Mm-hmm.
When you're speaking as truth from your truth, I respect you and your truth. All of us in this room have what we've come to know as our truth. And we're open to hearing you and what you believe as your truth. So don't think that anyone is attacking you.
No.
When it's a conversation, it's a dialogue.
Right. But you have to have order. And if I invite you to my house, and you my special guest, I'm going to have order. I'm going to make sure that everybody respects you until the end. You can have your own opinion. I'm not taking that away from you. I'm not a pastor. I would never throw my reality onto yours because we come from two different spiritual bloodlines. I would never do that. But at least have the decency to respect me if I'm here on my own accord. So that's all I'm asking for. Because if I invite you to a lecture and there's a lot of people in the room, you're not going to stop. You're not going to stop the pastor in the middle of his sermon and say, "Pastor, you wrong, da 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 da." He want to keep preaching, so all I ask is for the same respect. That's all I ask. It's no disrespect to you. You can say whatever you want to after this. You get what I'm saying? So let's get back. Let's get order. Let's get back. Let's get the energy back. I'm in a room. I've been in a room with 100 people who had different opinions, but it didn't stop me. They didn't stop me in the middle of my lecture. And we still talk today. It's that we have different energy. The physical will identify what we are. We're not kin because we're black. Somebody made that classification up. We black because somebody said we were black. We African because somebody said we were African. I'm not African. Because Africa is only 10% of the globe. And how you think, if you think that you're African, you're thinking on 10% of your brain. This is why we only think with 10% of our brain. Because the stretch of the geographical area that you claim is the way that you're going to think. You don't let nobody limit your distance and thought. So if somebody say you're African, you only think with 10% of your brain.
So how do we, and I get what you're saying, so how do we categorize said gods? You know what I mean? Like, how do we, when we're trying to express ourselves and ask certain questions, like, how should a person that's really into metaphysics, that really know the terminology, as opposed to the ones that don't necessarily, how do we kind of express or say certain things, for clarity?
The reason, I'm going to take it to the root. I'm going to try to break it down. Please stand up. All right, say I'm the beginning of God. Say I'm the first person who invented the word God, because again, we go back. God can't exist without the word first. I can't exist